How to make a wealthy man notice you. Ladies, the competition is tough today. And if you're ever going to land that affluent man, it's not only being part of high society that is required from you. You also need to beat the competition. How do we beat competition? It all boils down from being, first of all, noticed, because there is an array of women out there that crosses the paths with men on a daily basis. But how would you stand out to these men? How would you be the one who's noticed in their eye? Sadly, today there is this trend of thinking that more is more. Thinking that if you apply more makeup, if you put in more hair extensions, if you show more skin, then people think that that's going to get you noticed. That everyone in the room will look at you and want you to become their wife or girlfriend. Well, you hear how silly that sounds, right? You won't get the appropriate attention when you take this method. You will only attract guys who are not serious, men who maybe want to have an arrangement with you or maybe just some temporary fun. There are two different types of women that men want to marry or have a serious relationship with. And then, you know, the type of women who they just want to have for some pleasure seeking. So I'm going to give you three fundamental ways how you can first of all catch the right attention and of course be noticed at the same time. Number one, confidence. How confident do you look when you enter a room? How confident do you look when you just walk around? How confident do you look when you're sitting at a bar hoping to meet somebody? Many things you have to ask yourself when it comes to confidence. And you also have to understand that there is a right way of applying confidence. You don't want to have too much confidence because that can make you appear very masculine and you might scare people off. Another way of too much confidence is when you just behave like a diva. And that's not really the direction where we want to go either. And total lack of confidence makes you appear like a gray mouse type of thing. You might also attract the wrong people, people who might not have the best agenda, or maybe people who would like to use you and so on. So you have to understand that confidence is very important. If you want to be a woman who carries herself where people respect her, then you have to use confidence because that's what's going to give you and show people that you are a woman of value. In my online finishing school, I talk to my students all the time about the importance of image development, how you really have to have your image all figured out and very much on point. But that can only be applied and work if you use confidence, because confidence will people believe that message. You can wear a beautiful dress, you can wear a beautiful designer bag, but nobody's really going to believe that you are an affluent woman if you don't also carry yourself with that confidence, with that belief that you are her, that you are who you claim you are. So going back to how men are going to notice you thanks to confidence, think about it this way. You enter a room and you walk in confidently, not like arrogantly, not like you think you're the best and all that. A little bit of that is good because that is definitely going to boost your confidence level. But you want to walk into a room and feel like, in a way, like you own it, but not like you are better than everybody else, because that type of attitude always pushes people away. So when you have this confident walk, this confident posture, body movements, way of speech, everything that has to do really with body language, and add on top of that, that you're there beautifully dressed, perfectly groomed, and then you walk into this room, and the man will be like, who is this woman? Wow, interesting. You see, it's not very hard to be noticed, really, if you just use confidence. Even if you look not leveled up at all, if you walk confidently, if you are confident, people are going to notice you. Men are going to notice you. Men might get so infatuated by you when they see you walking in there, they might say to themselves, you know what? She might not be exactly the tenor that I wanted my woman to be, but wow, she fascinates me. Her confidence just radiates. I have to speak to her. I've seen this happen all the time. Ladies, Confidence is something that is free of charge, okay? You don't need to have money to have confidence. All you need is to start working on it. Once you have confidence, you can convince people to anything, literally. You will own the space. So make sure you really make use of confidence. Number two. Be elegant. There's a lot of beautiful women out there today. Beauty is extremely accessible today, even in the lower classes. Surgery, fillers, beauty treatments, it's not anymore just something for the rich. It's not something for those who have a good financial situation. Anyone can actually become more beautiful than how it was back in the days. So beauty is accessible, and that's why competition is tough, okay? However, I'm going to share with you a secret. And that is, there are many beautiful women out there. There are many sexy women out there. But you know what there's not many of today? That's elegant women. Elegant women are a rarity. And especially with how the whole kind of Kim Kardashian era and, you know, the current trends right now, elegance is not on top of people's minds. Now it's all about kind of looking casual and 90s and all kinds of different trends. If you, on the other hand, you behave elegantly, you dress elegant, you have an elegant body language, you are like an entire elegant package, you are going to stand out. You don't have to be, you know, on the level of the royal house, you don't have to be a Kate Middleton or Meghan Markle, but you have to have some form of elegance because it is a rarity. And you'd be surprised how much men in high society appreciate elegance. And I'm sure they will appreciate it because it is a rarity. So what can you do to be more elegant? Obviously, the whole theme of my online finishing school is teaching women elegance. So if you do want to learn more on that, go to schoolofaffluence.com and find out. You can also watch more of my videos on this channel. Go and have a browse after this video because I have plenty of free content that at least can give you a kickstart on how to level up and how to become more elegant in your everyday life. So having said that, elegance is important, but we still have one more. Number three, be feminine. Like I said in the previous point, there is already an abundance of sexy women. Sex is everywhere today. Unfortunately, sex sells, which is why everybody in today's society have just taken it and overusing it. Sex has become boring at the same time. We've seen it, we understand, okay, been there, done that. Now let's find something more interesting. So that's a little bit how men think. Men are not really impressed by sexuality as much as they were maybe before when it was more restricted. So they need something that would really catch their eye for attention. Plus also, I feel like, you know, dressing sexy, it is so unoriginal. It really does not make a person stand out today. School of Affluence is about elegance. It's about being a high value woman. We would not want to sell ourselves short this way. We wouldn't want to sell our soul just so that we can get noticed. We are not desperate for men on this channel. We want to catch attention of serious men, of men with potential, of men of high caliber. And such men tend not to seek out the skimpy looking girls. So what you must do for that reason, ladies, is focus on femininity. Again, it's a mantra in School of Affluence, but this is what hooks a man. This is what will make a man notice you. Who do you think men would rather approach in a room? Do you think they would approach Kim Kardashian? Or do you think they would approach Monica Bellucci? Because I think a comparison between these two is very, very good. You will notice the difference between sexy and feminine. They're more or less similar looking, but totally different styles. And I can promise you, I've heard million times more men raving about Monica Bellucci, how attractive, how sexy, how everything she is. Sexy is, of course, their way of describing how she attracts them because of this feminine power that she has. Whilst how many men do actually say that, oh my God, Kim Kardashian, I love her, she's so sexy, she's so attractive. I think you know the answer to this one. Femininity is something that I talk so much more about in my course, but I want you to think more how you can implement it in your life. Think about maybe if you can do it through body language, how you dress, or so and so on. Seek out some feminine role models, perhaps. By the way, if you still haven't watched my video, 6 Things That Turn Rich Men Off, then I really recommend you to watch it now. That was it for me, ladies. Go now and watch my next video.